In this video, we are going to see about the algorithms and its complexity. Different algorithms we are going to see. We are going to see the search algorithms as well as the sorting algorithm. Initially, we will see the method divide and conquer method. Here, this breaks. The name itself says divide and conquer, which means the main problem will be divided, and then again, the subproblem, it will be divided into subproblems, where the subproblems will be again, each subproblem will be divided again into further subproblems and so on in such a way that it cannot be further divided. And a solution for the lowest problem is, at the lowest level is formed. Then that will be substituted for the previous one and so on. Finally, they will be connected, all the solutions will be combined, and then the final solution will be obtained. So, for example, look at this picture. The problem, main problem, that will be divided into subproblem. This each subproblem is again divided into subproblem, and so on. Finally, here you can combine these two in order to get the solution for the previous steps, and so on. Finally, you combine, and then all these will be combined to get the final solution of the main problem. So this is called divide and conquer. This will be mostly used in recursive algorithms. So let me narrate the divide and conquer definitions. Breaks problem into subproblems that are similar to the original problem. So each subproblem will be of similar to the original problem. When you divide, it will have, that is, similar thing, similar operations only you can do with this divide and conquer. So recursively solves the subproblem and finally combine the solutions to the subproblem to solve the original problem. Because divide and conquer solves subproblems recursively, each subproblem must be smaller than the original. So if you divide this, this must be smaller than this. If you divide this, this must be smaller than this. This will be the bigger problem. Bigger problem between these, this will be the bigger problem of these two. So, and there must be a base case for the subproblem. Let us take, these are all the base case. So in this base case, it will substitute and get the solution for the next levels, and substitute, finally it will get the, or the solve the bigger problem. So you should think of a divide and conquer as having three parts. Divide the problem into number of subproblems that are smaller instances of the same problem. So each will be a small instance of the same type. So conquer the subproblem by solving them recursively. If they are small enough, solve the subproblems as the base case. So combine the solutions to the subproblem into the solution to the original problem. So this is why it is called divide and conquer. Now we'll see few algorithms which are based on this divide and conquer. Let's take binary search, finding maximum and minimum in an array, merge sort, quick sort, selection sort, etc. Now in this, we will see the binary search algorithm. So the name itself says it's a binary, the whole array is, if you take an array and many values in the array, and you are going to search for a particular value. Here, the first rule in the binary search is it must be in a sorted order. So for this algorithm to work, the input must be sorted. This is the first criteria. If you are going to do a binary search, the array must be in a sorted order, or else you cannot execute. Then it will become a linear search. So in the binary search, what you do is, after the sorting is done, you divide the array into two, and then you search whether your element is in the first half or the second half by comparing with the middle value. If the middle value is smaller than the one which you are searching, then your search has to be in the right hand side, that is the value which have more values, or you can say the right hand side of the array. If the searching value is lesser than the middle value, then you know that you have to search in the left hand side, which consists of smaller number of values, because already we have told you it is in a sorted array. So let us take, let A(i) 1 less than I less than be a list of elements that are sorted in a non-decreasing order. So it works, non-decreasing means in a ascending order. So it works by looking for a particular item by comparing the middle item. So always you divide it and compare the value, the one which you are going to search, with the middle value. If a match occurs, then we have obtained the value. then the index of the item is returned. If the middle item is greater than the item, then the item is searched in the subarray of the left of the middle item. Otherwise, the item is searched in the subarray to the right of the middle item. This process continues on the subarray as well until the size of the subarray reduces to zero. So if you take this, let us assume we have an array. First, let me explain this with an array and then we will see the algorithm. So here, if you see this, let us consider this as a value. So it is in an ascending order. That is increasing order. So these are all the indexes. So index is 0 and here 9. So what you have to do, you have to find the middle value. The value to be searched is 31. Let us imagine the value to be searched is 31. So first we will find the middle value, 0 plus 9. How you will be finding 0 plus 9 divided by 2. That is low plus high by 2. So this is low initially and this is high. This value is a high. So divided by 2, you get 4. You have to leave out the fraction part. You have to take only the integer portion. So 4.5 you will get, but we will take only 4. So 4 is the middle of the array. Now this is the middle of the array. Now you check this value, 27 with 31. Because 31 is what we are going to search. Since it is lesser than, okay, 31 is greater, but the middle value is lesser than the value to be searched, it must be definitely in the right hand side. So you have to leave the left hand side. So here we are dividing the problem into two and then we are reducing the search space. So by finding the middle value and searching, checking whether the middle value is greater or smaller than the searching item. So now you have to reduce your search only in this. You should not search this because it is already a sorted order. So you're searching here, it's a waste of time. So now you have to search in this. Then now from here, now what you have to do is already the middle value is 4. Now when searching, you have to change, since it is in the right hand side, where you have to make the low to be here. That is middle plus 1 now will become the low value and high is as usual. This is the same. High is the same in this case. So now what happened? This is the low and this is the middle. So 5, again you have to find the middle value in this. Now you have your search space is this and you have to apply the algorithm again. That is mid plus 1. Sorry. You have to find the mid. So low plus high by 2. So what happens? Low is 5. High is 9. So what happened? 5 plus 9 it is. Yes, 5 plus 9 it is 14. 14 by 2 it is 7 now. So here we have moved the middle low value to be mid plus 1. So it is 5. So 5 plus 9 it is 14 by 2. It is 7. So now the middle value is this. Now you again check your middle value. Because always we check the middle value only. Whether the middle value is equal to ours. At one point if the data is there, we correctly located our midpoint to be our searching answer. So here 35. Now 35, is it greater than our searching value or not? Here it is lesser. So now your search must be in the left hand side. So now you have to leave these two values. Along with this, you have to leave. Along with the middle value, you have to leave. Now already low value is there, but now you have to move the high value as mid minus 1. So now 6 becomes the high. So here, high equal to mid minus 1, which is 7 minus 1, which is nothing but 6. So now, again, you have to find the mid value of these two. So low plus high, already low is 5. Now high is changed to 6. So 5 plus 6 by 2, it is 11 by 2, it is 5. So when you search, now you again, you check whether your value is equal to the searching value. Yes, now that mid value is 31, which is equal to our searching value, and we have found the value. So if you take this, this is the first division, and then this is the second division, and then third division. So in the fourth, we have got the answer. So this is the algorithm for binary search. So A is a sorted array, which is nothing but our this array. Then n is the size of the array. According to our algorithm, we have 10 elements in that array. So n will be 10. Then x is the value to be searched, which is nothing but our 31 here, the value which is to be searched. So first initially, low is made to 1, high is made to n, which is nothing but our 9.
isn't it? Index. Here, n means here is nothing but index of the value. Now, while low is less than or equal to high, actually here low is 0. Okay. So, here I can change this according to our algorithm. It is 0. Okay. So, here 0 and here it is 9 now. So low is less than or equal to high. You keep doing. You have to find, always find the mid value, and always you have to check with the mid value whether the mid value is less than x. If the mid value is less than the value which you are going to search, then you have to make the low value to be mid plus 1, because we know that the value is higher. This, if the mid value is less than, the value is high, okay, than the mid. So, which means it must be in the right hand side. So, you make the move the low to be from here to that. So, you are incrementing from mid, after mid you are taking it as a low. The else, it must be in the left hand side. So, now you have to change the higher value. So, high becomes mid minus 1. You have to leave the mid. In both the cases, you have to leave the mid. So, mid minus 1. So, you keep doing that. Then finally, you will be getting the answer. So in this case, we are dividing the big problem into smaller and smaller by finding the middle point, and then we make the low and high respectively so that the problem is reduced, and then further reduced till there is no, it becomes zero, and finally we will get the answer. If we don't get the answer, it means the value is not at all present. Now let us take another example. Here these are the elements. Totally from 1 to 40. So here we start from 1, not 0, 0 index, here 1 to 40. So if you take this, let us consider the searching element is 151. X equal to 151, let us take. So what is the low and high now? Initially low is 140. So when you add these two, 14 plus 1, 15. 15 by 2, it is 7 point, which is nothing but we have to take only 7. So now you check 7th value, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 is here. It is lesser than 151. So our search space has to be, it has to be removed from this. Now it starts from, now mid plus 1 becomes a low value. So now here it is 8. After 7 becomes 8. So 8 to here still it is 14. So 8 plus 14, it is 22 by 2, it is 11. So 8, 9, 10, 11. Now this is your middle value. So now what happens? Again, you check this value with the 151. It is greater. 151 is greater. So now again, it will be here in the right hand side. So now mid is changed to this. That is 11 plus 1, it is 12. Now it becomes. Now what you do is, this is the low value and this is the high value. Now what you do, you add these two and divide by 2. So 12 plus 14, 26 by 2, it is 13. Now here this is 13. So 13, you check. Now you make the, it is not equal. 13 is not equal to 151. Still it is, 151 is greater. So what you happen, you what you do, 13 plus 1, you do the low value to be. Now 14. 14 plus 14, it is 28, which is divided by 2. Again, it is 14. Now you check whether it is equal to, yes, we have found the match. Now let us take another example, minus 14. Now when you do is, here minus 14 is not at all present. So what we do first, initially it is 1 and 14, it is 7. Then it is, when we check the 7 value, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yes, 54. Definitely 54, minus 14 is less than 54. So you leave all these things and high becomes here, 23. So 1 is the same thing, but this becomes less. So high value becomes 6. Now you again, 6 plus 1, 7, 7 by 2, it is 3. Then you check whether mid, 1, 2, 3, 0. So still 0 is greater than minus 14. So now what you do is, you make the high to be the 2. So now 2, now it is 2, and then you check 1 plus 2 by 2, it is 3 by 2, it is again 1.
So now you are checking whether one, this is the one. So it is equal to, no. So it is still lesser than. So what you do, you try to increment. Since it is minus 14 is greater than minus 15, you try to increment the value. So here it becomes 2. After this, 2 low becomes 2 and high becomes 1. So which is according to our algorithm, we do that and it is not found. It comes out according to our algorithm what it is. Well, while low is less than high, in that case only you will search. But now it becomes what happens here, high becomes lower than that, low becomes more. So it quits and it returns 0. That is, it is not found. Then x equal to 9, same way. So here also we divide it and we get the 7. 7th element is this. So it goes here. Our search will be here. So high becomes 6. And then 1 plus 6, it is 3. Then we check the 3 value. No, it is not. It is 9 is greater than. So our search has to be within this. So now the low becomes 4. And high is still then. Then 4 plus 6, it is 10. 10 by 2, 5. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we check that this 5, A of 5 is equal to our search element. Yes. Now it is 4 and it gives the answer. Now if you see this, in each iteration, the array is divided by half. So let's say the length of the array at any iteration is n. At iteration 1, the length of the array will be 1, n. At 2, it becomes n by 2. It is divided. Again, at the next one, this n by 2 is further divided, again divided. So it is n by 2 square. So after the kth iteration, you keep on doing kth iteration, it will be 2 power k. So we know that after k divisions, the length of the array becomes 1. So finally, it becomes 1. So in that case, you can equate n by 2 per k equal to 1, which is nothing but n equal to 2 power k. Applying the log functions on both sides, we get log 2 of n 2 2k. So according to our equation, that is this a equal to 1, we substituted here. So what happens here? See here, we substitute a. So here 2 2, here we substitute 1. So log 2 n equal to k. This is the complexity of this algorithm. So now if we see the here, it's given in the table. If 1, then log n is 0. If it is 2, 1. If it n number of values is 4, then log n will give. That is, this will give the complexity. So the worst case is log n. Best case, maybe at the first search itself, we may find the answer. In that case, it is order of 1. Average case and worst case are the same. And worst case space complexity of order of 1. The logarithm function, it grows very slowly. So even if you have 512 elements, you can find the search within the 9 comparison, 9 division. That's what the meaning of this. So even if you have this much number of elements, okay, this much number of elements, you will find your, if the data is present in that array, you will find the value within this 21 comparison, 21 divisions, you will be finding your answer. So that's what it says. That is why the log n is said to be the best in any searching methods.